You're just jealous because her husband's back.
There's only so much happiness in the world, Mark, and they're hoarding it all.
That's not how happiness works.
It completely is.
Yeah, what would you know about love or happiness?
What's that supposed to mean? Are you saying I'm some sort of emotional cripple who can't express their feelings, and that's why Sophie didn't want to go out with me? You are! You're saying it with your face and body! Well, if you're going to say something as horrible as that, at least have the decency to use words.
All right, Mark. I heard you and Soph went to a circle jerk. Did you have a good time, did you? You know we went for dinner after.
Oh, really?
Pretty knackered, actually. You know, from giving it to her long and hard all night.
Blimey, Jeff. How amazing. I suppose I might as well give up on Sophie and leave her totally to you.
Really?
No, you can fuck off.
Follow me.
He hates it. He bloody hates it.
This is a fun game. Now, face me, yeah? Now, pick a movie, any movie, I bet you I've got it.
Il Postino.
Yeah, be serious, something proper.
Passport to Pimlico.
No. Don't look.
Scarface.
Exactly. Thank you. There you go. You can have that if you want. Come with me. These are my guys. They had to pull a lady, so I was all do it around my place. I've got a fridge full of beers. Plus, this way, I get to keep an eye on.
Tell him I'm not here.
Why?
Because I didn't confront him, all right?
Oh, hi, Daryl.
Hey, Jez, is Mark around?
He's not, I'm afraid. He's gone out. To get a Thai curry.
Right. Do you mind if I come in and wait? I mean, I'd call him, but I think his mobile's fucked, you know. So, how's it going?
Yeah, good, actually. I was just going to listen to some rather wicked music. Yeah, I love reggae. It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, sure.
Of course, there's a lot more to black culture than just music, obviously. Did you know it was a black man who invented golf, but then he wasn't allowed to play on any of the courses? It's kind of sick, isn't it?
Yeah. Is it all right if I use the bug?
No, it's broken. Let's watch a Woody Allen movie.
No thanks, Jeremy.
No. Bit too clever for his own good, is he? Woody Allen.
I just don't think he's very funny.
And no doubt you find the film Twins, starring Arnold Schwarzenegger, simply hilarious.
Look, I'm sorry if you find it threatening that me and Mark don't believe everything we're told.
Oh yeah? Oh yeah? Well, look at this, Daryl. This is the future. Black men holding white babies. And you better get used to it because it's very, very lovely.
Jeremy?
Hello? Oh, my goodness. Sophie, hi.
This is Mark's flatmate, Jez.
Oh, right.
What are you doing down here?
Oh, nothing. Just getting a round in. I fucking love this game, don't you?
Yeah, it's fun.
Well, nice to meet you, mate. We should...
Before you go, I just wondered, what do you think about all those bloody pedos and the terrorists, eh?
What do you mean?
Get him to say the pedos and the terrorists should have the death penalty. That's what he thinks.
I mean, what do you think? Do you think we should, you know, string them up? The bombers and the nonces. Let them swing.
Look, mate, we're just trying to play a game of crazy golf. So, another time.
Don't let them go. He doesn't think date rape counts as rape. Subtly ask him about date rape.
Okay, well, have a nice rest of your date. Hope it doesn't end in date rape.
See you later.
Say hi to Nancy for me.
Look out. A couple of high street honeys at 3 o'clock.
God, this is so butch. If I was with Mark, we'd just be sitting in the corner rating the Alcopops.
Right. Mine's the blonde.
What, really? What about Nancy? Or Sophie?
Jez, we're not going to do anything. We're just going over.
It's probably our turn to go on the pool table. Although, looks like those guys...
They haven't jumped the fucking queue, have they?
Maybe they're not from round here. I'll go and put some more coins down. They probably don't understand what the coins mean.
Everybody knows what the coins mean. Come on, let's sort it out.
Oh my God, we're a pair of men entering a combat situation. I'm gonna fight for my territory. It's fight or flight. Flight. No, fight. Fight. Flight.
What's going on, mate?
Don't think. Just hit. Can't hit. Talk. Yeah, talk. Let Jeff hit. All right, so do you want some? Some treatment, yeah? Do you want some? Big time? Well, let's do it, my friend. Let's do the Hucklebuck. Right now! Right bloody here!
Oh, Jez, it's all right.
What?
They're Polish. They didn't know about the coins.
Oh, right. Right, sorry. Welcome to our kingdom. We do the coins here.
Have you got the sign in? Can you see the sign? Hey, Sophie, come on, be in the photo too.
Rod, this is Sophie. Sophie jumped as well. Come on, let's get Sophie in the picture too.
Alan, we talked about this, I really don't feel comfortable.
Why not?
Because they didn't jump. Sophie wanted to, but Mark bottled it.
You didn't jump?
Oh, that is outrageous. Most certainly...
Careful, Nixon, Aitken, is the cover-up that screws you.
Actually, I can't recollect exactly what happened on that day.
What are you trying to tell me, Mark? Oh, for God's sake, Mark. Rod, I'm terribly sorry about this. I have no idea.
I hope you're pleased with yourself, Jeff. Yeah, well done, mate. Because the real loser here isn't me. It's diabetes treatment. Yeah, Jeff, you've given diabetes a big boost. I hope you're pleased, you fucking diabetes lover.
The dream is dead. Farewell, Sophie. Farewell, Reminisso package. The Boots lunch mega deal I bought her when she forgot her purse. $2.99. Never even asked for it back. Was keeping hair from her comb weird? Only if I'd glued it to a doll. I never even considered gluing it to a doll. Goodbye, Sophie.
Oh, I see. I have to recycle everything, but you get to have wicked bonfires. Mark, are you okay?
Just... saying goodbye to Sophie.
What happened?
Told her today that I'm over her. She said we should stay friends.
Friends? Shit. Sorry.
I know.
Shall I leave you alone?
No, it's fine. I mean, I might cry, but if you don't mind seeing that.
Yeah. I'll probably go then. Deluxe or standard reception platter? Yeah, right, that's a toughie. If we order standard, the guys from the Home Office are going to be onto us like a shot.
Do we have to spend all that much? I mean, Jez, we've got to keep this phony marriage separate from our real relationship.
No, sure. I agree, totally. But you've got to have a deluxe platter. And coordinated cummerbunds and cufflinks. Without a properly coordinated cufflink, the guys from the Home Office are going to be onto us like a shot. They're gonna smell a huge rat.
The thing is, money's really tight for me right now. My boss found out about the visa thing. I'm out of a job.
But what about your savings?
Yeah. Last month I felt so guilty about those I gave them all to UNICEF. And now they are being really fucky about giving them back.
Okay, well, don't worry. A husband's first job is to look after his wife.
But I know how you feel about working, Jez. You showed me your poster.
Yeah. But there are loads of areas for creatives like me to get involved in, like architecting or trainers. I'll be fine.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you'll forgive me, I haven't prepared a proper speech. But then, perhaps that's appropriate, since this isn't a proper wedding. Or so the cynics may say. But I say to those cynics, listen, cynics, this is the modern world, and just because it's new and strange and unnerving doesn't mean it's not brilliant. I mean, take graphite tennis rackets, for example. Now, you may argue that they've forever destroyed tennis as a spectator sport by making the serve an overly mighty weapon, and you'd be right. But look me in the eye and tell me they're not a hell of a lot better than the wooden ones. And that, my friends, is called progress. In ancient Rome, they had Cupid. In modern days, it's the Home Office. Love is blind. That's not a joke about David Blunkett. No, seriously, I would never make that joke. So I say to Jeremy and... Where's Nancy?
Job interview. Health club. It's a biggie.
Oh. Okay. I say to Nancy, good luck with the interview. And I say to Jeremy, good luck with the marriage. And I think the rest of us can unite in all saying... Two fingers to the cynics, and raising our glasses to true love.
True love.
Jez, you want to watch a movie?
Sure, yeah, that would be nice.
Okay, Bicentennial Man, Patch Adams, What Dreams May Come.
I think Face Off might actually be on later, and Mark and I...
Uh-huh, right. It's just, I love Robin Williams. You know, he's got a special twinkle, hasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he has.
What I like most about him is his moist-eyed camera hogging.
Exactly. Okay, Jacob the Liar.
What is it?
It's kind of like a Holocaust comedy. But that makes it sound like it's in bad taste, which it isn't. It's in very good taste. Hardly anyone dies. They don't go on and on and on about it. You know what I mean? Ready. That's left. Thank you.
Next. Ready. The best bit is when they say, you're commissioned. You've got a show. And at that point, it could be the funniest thing ever. There is no limit to how brilliant it could be and how fantastic your future could be as a result.
It's the
and
gap
every
in between
stage
that.
Thereafter, mm. you get more worried and you think, was that decision a fuck up?
The stages of writing Peep Show, we start sort of 7 or 8 months before the filming begins, as you know, where we would do all our scene by scenes of what's going to happen in each episode.
Of course, this show has a fantastic advantage of being able to hear the thoughts of the two main characters. So we've always had a fantastic way to sort of add exposition to the story to bring it on track if we felt we were going off.
That's the most in sort of when you've got the most freedom, but also quite anxiety making because you're spending a lot of time coming up with these ideas and then giving them to the producer and the channel and hoping particularly the channel don't say we hate things about Nazis, that's not funny, you know, got think up a new idea of something that's funny.
Sam, what are you doing? Are you writing an episode of Peep Show?
Actually, I'm writing a hit list of all people I'm going to kill and you're on the top of that.
Everything's fucked.
Calm down, Jez. It's going to be okay.
Rehearsing is 2 weeks. Go through the scripts every day, talk about what we could add, mm-hmm. you know, what bits seem a bit flabby.
During rehearsal and before rehearsal, we're kind of punching up and making quite a lot of changes.
Would you consider marrying me? Obviously.
Yes!
It's relentless sometimes. Oh, you think, enough already.
Stop.
With the jokes. Is everyone so sad they need all these jokes?
Everything's still gold. It's shit.
Then shooting is 6 or 7 weeks, and we're sort of in pretty much every day, because every scene has got either Mark or Jeremy in, and many have both.
Mm.
We're both on set as well, because we're associate producers. And
you're quite proud of that, aren't you?
I'm very proud of that. And, yeah, we're both associate producers on the show. We take it in turns, rather sweetly, so that one of us can get a good night's sleep and a late morning.
Lord it over everyone else who doesn't get to do that,
yeah.
And become popular.
The show is all shot very uniquely, as you know from seeing the programme. It's all shot from the first-person perspective. And in terms of whether that's hard or easy, it's probably the easiest show I've ever had to direct in my life, because one of the hardest things about directing is you know, where are you going to put the camera, where are you going to put the actors. So you only have one of those elements is removed, because I know exactly where I'm going to put the camera, because it's where the people are standing. And so you can have much more fun with the blocking, knowing that I'm just going to put the cameras where the actors are. So it's incredibly easy.
Cut.
Cut there, thank you.
I think it's a lot more difficult shooting it.
Yeah, because you can't look into someone's face when you're acting with them. That's hard, not being able to read what's happening on the face of the actor you're meant to be doing it with.
And action!
So, basically, man is programmed to do two things, yeah? Kill and nob. In the Stone Age, we'd get up, kill an antelope.
And nob the corpse.
No, Jess.
I think I was talking to the producer and he said, look, filming's horrible. It's fine. You don't have to enjoy this. I hate filming. Filming's rubbish. Everybody's tired and they're stressed and nothing's ever as good as you think it's going to be. And God, it's horrible. And that really cheered me up. Just the knowledge that, you know, I wasn't alone. And obviously there are bits that you enjoy, but often, you know, making comedy isn't much fun.
I think the awful thing is it's really tiring and worrying while you do it. And then you really miss it.
You know, we had this sort of little digital mini cam, which the poor actors had to wear this sort of like potholder's helmet, which they could, you know, look, and it's great for sort of eating food and getting really close to the other people.
I remember the scene where Mark is brooming Jeff through the door in episode 5 as a highlight, because that scene worked really well. It's like well choreographed and very well directed, and all the actors were great. And I never realised what an incredible phallic symbol that was until we actually filmed it. A man thrusting a red broom handle through a letterbox repeatedly, screaming swear words.
I'm going to give you the broom, Jeff! I'm going to broom you!
I think the bits I like shooting most are where I just have to sit still and talk. So I like the scene...
He loves this.
Yeah, I like the scene with the sausage and Johnson talking about, you know, it's racist to put a sausage on a German's office door. That was fun because it was a really funny scene. It had a nice, easy prop that stayed still, and we could sit comfortably, and it wasn't too hot or too cold, and I wasn't in a lake or in a balloon.
Oh, God.
You all right, Mark?
Yes. No, I don't know.
What's the matter?
I think I'm actually very hungry. How about, shall we not jump and just have lunch?
I'm a great big believer in fructose, always have been.
The assumption is that everyone every day has a massive fried breakfast.
I love full English breakfast. I love sausages and bacon and eggs in that combination.
I'm really quite a fascinating figure because, you know, who can tell what I'm going to have for breakfast? Often I don't even know. I just march up there and, you know, it's like a veggie sausage one day, another day it's some muesli. I mean, it must be just a joy for people around me to get that kind of variety.
The idea is for me not to become a big fat idiot.
Has morning coffee at about 11 with nice biscuits. They have a big three-course lunch.
What are you eating today, Sam?
I'm eating vegetarian pork shank.
Vegetarian?
Well, I'm just trying to have the best of both worlds, actually. What are you doing, Phil? You got a hunger for other people's lives. Is that your problem?
And then at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, you have cake and sandwiches, because that's what happens.
And you do that for 7 weeks and then book yourself into a clinic.
We feel disgusting. There's no other way of putting it. We eat it down because we're pigs who just see food and eat it because we're bored. And I think it should be stopped, but none of us can stop it. It's like an addiction. I think the whole thing's revolting, frankly.
It gets a little bit more serious in the edit now because we've got the footage and we're going to cut it together, and it's sort of a bit like you spend a lot of time getting ingredients from the market, cooking them up, and you know the proof of the pudding is in the eating, so it's really a very delicate stage of the production.
The first rough cut I find a very awkward thing. It's the first time that I'm watching my own performance, and I think that's the, as an actor, that's the most difficult time. That's when you look the most fake to yourself, and it's also that's before they've added the sound properly. It all looks very rough and red. It doesn't look like a proper program, and you kind of look at it and think, oh God, that can't go on TV.
We can't throw that all away just because I spy on you, can we?
It's all anxiety, isn't it, all the way?
Yeah, it's like increasing anxiety until you get to sort of a volcano of stress sort of around filming. And then it gets worse in the editing because you're chopping whole scenes up and you're changing endings. And then it doesn't, until it's finally on television, it doesn't get any less stressful, really.
It's and then you wait for the reviews to come out and then the ratings and then are you going to get another series?
It goes on and on, relentlessly. It's like a hideous carnival of pain.
I got the commission!
Well, congratulations.
Shove it up your ass! Shove it up your ass! I've got a commission! It's big and it's fat and it's going right up your white bread ass.
Jez, for God's sake, I'm pleased for you!
Oh yeah, sure you are. So pleased that I've gone straight to the finish line on my enormous bike while you're still jogging along for miles in the rat race with you and all the other rats.